Okay, nevertheless, welcome everybody to the experience sharing. I'm so excited that Tanja is there, who will correct me at any time, please, when I'm talking nonsense. But yeah, I'm Harald Lauritsch, or simply Hardy. I'm just a facilitator. I'm really not an expert, and I, in fact, have one no formal nomination as a community manager, but I accompanied communities out there in our company and beyond. And yeah, I'll tell about some experience that we made in applying the community canvas. And I'm really curious about your opinions on that and also on your experiences. Yeah, so I'm going to share about 99 slides. Okay. Of course, I'm kidding. And let's see. How to do that right now? Because I lost it somehow, and nevertheless, okay, I'm simply share my main screen. Okay. Yeah, that's about it. Just a real brief introduction. No, it's not a real introduction. The community canvas is, as all canvases, an ability to put on one page what your community, what your community is about. So it focuses on the identity, on the purpose, and the idea of when is a community successful, and also on the values and brand of the community, on the identity, and so on and so forth. The experience section in red is about the real things that can be observed. So it's about experiences that can be made in the community, the content that is discussed, changed, exchanged, whatever there. Maybe some rituals, whatever this is. It depends on the community, if it's a frequent meeting or whatever you have in mind on that. And maybe there are also some rules about the behavior of the community, about yeah, what shall be discussed in the community, what not. Also about roles. And last not least, about how to enter the community and how to leave the community. And in fact, there is also maybe a need for getting some.
Different aspects. Before I dive more into the Mindful Open Online Dialogue, just a short introduction
really
what
I
the
have here some.
SLF on the.
Okay. You are still there?
Yes.
Because I had maybe
Yeah, some
out
of the
of
guests were
session
not
one.
muted. Some
Okay.
of the guests are not muted.
Okay. Okay, I'm simply go on. We have the green section about the structure and infrastructure of a community. So about electronic channels and platforms, maybe whatever, about how to manage the data. And also, of course, if there is a need for organization, about governance and maybe also financing. Well, and what we faced is the situation that, yeah, okay, there are some more details on that, leading questions about these areas. I will re not really cover it because it doesn't matter for today, I guess. Maybe if you have questions, we can talk about that later on that. What we faced was that we have a real small existing community, about 10 people, who are so-called multiplier communities, is a multiplier communities that has the idea or the goal to multiply insights about lean approaches, about lean methods, and so on and so forth. And there is another community that was just in the founding process. What is about, yeah, let's simply call it cultural transitions and transformations. And the idea was to get some more insights about what is the real community about and what the participants and the interested people feel what should be the purpose, what should be the identity, what should be the success definition, and so on and so forth, we set up some workshops and based on the community canvas. So for this existing community, I forgot to mention the one was about 10 people and the other one was about 40 people. We set up an invitation, opened a whiteboard, a shared whiteboard. In this case, we used a concept board. Here, obviously, you see the community canvas for individual breakout sessions to give the people the ability to talk about, to leave their contributions, and so on and so forth. And we also provided them in advance with some information about guiding questions to the respective areas of the board or of the canvas. We, in fact, did not spend too much time to talk about the real basics on that. We also do not talk too much about what is a community. There are several definitions on that. We simply tried to make the space open for all this contribution, all these concerns, and whatever ideas that come up. So, nevertheless, what we started with is to explain the people about what we call an ordered community. That is a community that is ordered or desired by management, and that should address the people out there who, for instance, should know something about lean methods and application of these methods. And for that, we have this multiplier community as a nucleus who is ordered by management, in fact, and also impacts and have all these whatever needs to be done or whatever formats they come up with, talk to this army of volunteers out there who might be interested in, who might be also get curious in joining this multiplier community, whatever. And for that, we also explain them in advance about these principles or differences of the communities. First of all, that their multiplier community has an internal purpose and as well an external purpose. That is, the internal purpose is to make the multiplier community work well, perform well, so that everybody feels fine on that and also is able to work on the goals and on the actions for that. But to have the fact in mind that they are addressing an separate external community. To show it in the canvas perspective, the outer community, this army of volunteers and interested people, is represented by that. And there is a specific role in the outer community that is applied or fulfilled by the multiplier community. So the multiplier community is a community itself which serves the outer community. And for that, we thought it's a very good idea that we go into the discussion with a kind of defined purpose and also a success definition. Because why that? Obviously, because it's an ordered community. So we assembled what we heard out of the stakeholders of management, also what we have in mind as a community manager or associated people to come up into the discussion with a predefined purpose. But we also told them that they should state about that they should argue and whatever needs to be done to streamline, to adapt, or whatever is necessary from the perspective of the multiplier community or the individuals in there. This is just an example. So I crossed out our company internals, but you got it, at least the idea to come up with a predefined purpose and a success definition. Yeah, and then the workshop went on. Here you have some consolidated results of this bigger community that was really in the foundation process. So we had about think I, if I remember right, a 2-hour session on that, or yeah, maybe 3 hours in total, so that the people came up really with their ideas, what could be the target, what could be the identity. As you can see, there were quite some contributions. Out of these 40 people, I guess we had about 25 participants for this meeting. And what really turned out unexpectedly fine, that people simply had the energy to state that they want to work on details about the individual areas, for instance, about the contents. Here, they took out the cards by themselves and tried to make some real statements for the community, let's say, charter. So they worked on that, and we are still in the process of adjusting, of learning, and also of identifying different approaches, different opinions, and so on and so forth. One of the learnings that I'll at least summarize later was definitely that unexpectedly, at least for me, we had a real, real bandwidth of opinions, contradicting opinions. And it was really quite interesting to observe how the people exchanged these opinions. In most cases, try to learn from each other, to accept each other, to acknowledge the different opinion, and make a synergetic suggestion what should be in the individual areas. And on the other hand, there have been found some conflicting things that caused people to leave the community because they found that it's not in their intention, in their mindset, that we should work like that. But this is a real steep learning for them and for us as well. But what I really feel is that that prevented us from approaching in whatever actions, and then afterwards, and in the meantime or in the flow, find out that there are different expectations on that. The other community, the smaller one, these 10 people, as you can see a snapshot here out of the concept boards, they identified also areas to work on, it developed and emerged some actions that have been never intended like that, but they are derived definitely from the outcomes of the community canvas. It's about communication, so they set up a calendar for events that about the shared experience and contents, and so on and so forth. So it's really gained its own dynamics. Also, they came up with the idea of having a retro on all that stuff, and learn and adapt the canvas as well. Our learnings in a brief summary. The community members really sharpened their awareness of what the community is, should be, and so on and so forth, all the actions. The community managers and stakeholders got a feedback that was, in some perspective, surprising for them. We detected various, even conflicting, anticipations about these communities. One learning is definitely to allow a 15% completeness, in quotes, about completeness, consistency, accuracy. So don't overstress the canvas. There's no need to discuss everything in one step. Allow iterations and allow learnings. And accept different personalities, because there are people who really don't want to talk too much about the goals and success definitions, but they want to go into action. So they are more about shared experiences and content and whatever. And even the warners are welcome because they contribute things that we should take care about. And also accept participation denials for people who say, hey, let's simply do something. I don't want to discuss too much. As I mentioned, the follow-up initiatives partially arise automatically by intrinsic motivations out of the community, and they are still ongoing. And if not, whatever, foster retros and look forward for iterations that come up. And our conclusion is that our canvas grows, develops, adapts, and represents the real current and actual state of the community. And my final pitch is it's worth the time. So this was my real brief and short. No, it was really not too short, but we have 10 minutes left on your discussions, questions, whatever needs to be said right now.